Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn a poem, Indian Rivers. It is written by Sarojini Naidu. It is one of our best-known poems in English. Here is the poem, Indian Rivers. But before going to learn the meaning of the poem, let me tell you that there are 3 stanzas in the poem, and each stanza depicts one state of man's life. We all know that there are 3 stages of man's life. First is childhood, second is young age, and the last stage is old age. So each stanza in the poem depicts one stage of man's life. Here is the poem, Indian Rivers. The first stanza that I am going to read is: Rivers, weaving at break of day, why do you view a garment so gay, blue as the ring of a halcyon wife? We view the robes of a newborn child. This is the first stanza of the poem. But before going further, what is the meaning of the first stanza? Let me tell you that there is a question in the first 2 lines and last 2 lines of the first stanza is answer. There is answer in the last 2 lines of the first stanza. If there is question in the first stanza, so we have to know who asked the questions or who is the questioner that asked the question in the first 2 lines. The question is, weavers, weaving at break of day, why do you view a garment so gay? So the questioner may be someone, or the questioner may be poetess herself. But that is not known to us, that is unknown, because we don't know who is the questioner. But in the first stanza, someone asked Rivers. What does he ask? Or what does she ask? She asked, why are you weaving a garment that is gay, that is so bright and beautiful? And also they are asking, also he or she, or questioner, is asking, why you have chosen a time of early morning. The weavers are weaving a cloth. They are weaving a cloth early in the morning. So a questioner asks the weavers, why have you chosen the time of early morning to view the robes? And the robe is so gay, that means so bright and beautiful. So the weavers give answer to the questioner. They say, blue as the ring of a halcyon wife. We are weaving the cloth. With the cloth that is blue in color, like the colors of halcyon. What does halcyon mean? It is kingfisher. Halcyon means kingfisher. We are weaving the cloths like the plumes of kingfisher. That is a bird. You might have seen kingfisher, or here is the picture of kingfisher, you can see. So we are weaving cloths like the plumes. Plumes means soft feathers. Soft feathers, that is the plumes. Plumes means piece. Jala apan piece manto marathi madhe pakshane je piece astat tyala plumes mantat, feathers mantat. Kingfisher ya pakshancha pankha pramane nire aslele kapde ami unat aho. The weavers give answer to the question. that we are weaving the cloths, and they are of, or it is of blue color, like the plumes or feathers of a kingfisher. For whom we are weaving that? Yes, definitely. We are weaving these clothes for a newborn child. Look at, there are two words. Break of day, that is the beginning of the day. Break of day, that means it is early in the morning. That means the day, it is the beginning of the day. And here the weavers are weaving the clothes for a newborn child. That means a child that is going, that is about to going to start his journey. So the first stanza depicts the first stage of man's life, that is childhood. The second stanza is weavers weaving at fall of night. Why do you weave garment so bright? In the second stanza, question it is asking question to the weavers, that weavers weaving at fall of night, why do you weave a garment so bright, like the plumes of a peacock, purple and green? We weave the marriage veil of a queen. The first, I have told you that there is a question in the first lines, and the question is, why do you weave garment so bright, and at the time of fall of night? Here fall of night meaning is late night, that is twilight, or you can say that late night. You are weaving the garment at fall of night. So the weaver answered that, why are you weaving the clothes so bright and at fall of night, at twilight, or you can say at late of night? The weaver said that, weavers give the answer or give response, reply to the question of that, we are weaving the clothes that is purple and green in color, like the plumes of a peacock. Peacock, more. Moranchya pankha pramane, plumes means soft feathers. Plumes means soft feathers. Moranchya pankha pramane, ammi, we are weaving clothes for, we are weaving clothes, marriage veil of a queen. Eka ranicha, kiwa eka stricha, lagna sathi kapde ammi, that's why they are so bright and they are purple and green in color. So here is the second stanza. The question is that the questioner asks to the viewers that why are you weaving garments so bright and why have you chosen the time of late night? So the viewers say, we have chosen the night time to view this particular cloth, that is marriage veil of a queen, because it is the time of romance, it is a romantic time, or it is the beginning of the wedded bliss. So the second stage of man's life, so wedding or marriage, for giving the marriage veil of a queen. And the last stage, or the, I would say, last stanza of the poem is, weavers weaving solemn and still. The moonlight chill. The questioner asks to the weavers, you have chosen the time of, you are weaving the cloth solemnly and peacefully. Solemnly means, and
Why do you view in the moonlight shape? White as a feather and white as a cloud. We view a dead man's funeral shroud. Shroud is here. A cloth in which a dead person is wrapped. ज्याला मराठीत आपण म्हणू प्रेत वस्त्र, की ज्यामध्ये त्या प्रेताला पांढरे प्रेत पांढरा कपडा की ज्यामध्ये प्रेताला गुंडाळल्या जाते. हिंदीत त्याला आपण कफन म्हणतो. दॅट इज अ क्लॉथ इन विच ए डेड पर्सन इज रॅप्ड, दॅट इज कॉल्ड श्राउड. सो द क्वेश्चनर आस्क्ड द व्यूअर्स, विविंग सोलेन व्यूअर्स, विविंग सोलेन अँड स्टील, why do you view in the moonlight shade? Viewers, you reply to the questioner, white as a feather and white as a cloud. We view a dead man's funeral shroud. Now we have chosen the type of, we are viewing the cloth silent, seriously and peacefully. We are living the most seriously and peacefully because we are living shroud for a dead man. And here Poetess says that they have chosen a type of moonlight chill. That means here chill, moonlight cannot be chill. Chill means thunder. Here the poet has used word chill for a dead person or on the body of a dead person. So we were viewing solemn and still. The questioner asks, why do you view in the moonlight chill? White as a feather and white as a cloud. We view a dead man's funeral shroud. This is the meaning of the poem Indian Viewers.